Γεια σου καλημέρα, γεια σου καληνύχτα, γεια σου καληνότσες. This is Jon V the Magnificent. This is Jon V the Magnificent in one more pitch deck review for your pleasure. What we do here every week around every Thursday, we review one pitch deck that you send me in the address that is right here, I assume, yes. And you send it to me, I review it, people watch it, maybe you get some investors interested. Surprisingly, in 2022, like that's this year, we made a couple of investments on pitch decks that we saw and reviewed on this channel. If you want to get some feedback about your pitch deck, if you want to know if you did something wrong, or if you want to know if you did something extremely well, or maybe you just want a little bit more exposure for your startup, I'm here to help. Please subscribe and like this video because that's how I know that you really like this content. And let's start reviewing the next startup, shall we? The interesting thing with every startup that I review is that I've never seen their pitch deck before. I literally see the pitch deck right now with you. And this is the reaction that any angel investor will have when they first see your pitch deck. So it's totally authentic. Let's go. Reimagining everyday essentials. Okay, I think I have an idea, and that's very good. Like when you start your slide and I have an idea about what your product is about, it's actually very, very good. I think that it has something to do about creating alternatives for our everyday essential, like things that we use in the bathroom. Huge market. I love the space. I'm very excited to see what's next. Our customer, the problem market size. Let me see and let me think. Consumers want brands to help them become more environmental friendly and ethical. I really like that the first slide is about the problem. Like, what is the problem? Every slide should start with what's the problem that you're trying to solve. I don't care who you are. I don't care what university you graduated from. I don't care. The only thing I care, what's really the problem? Like, get me into your pitch deck, and this is a good slide. Consumers want brands, industry lacks transparency. I like the underlining that highlights the things that I should be focusing on. So this brand is about environmentally friendly brands and being ethical in our daily life. I get the vibe, very nice. First slide, and I already know what you're doing, which is very good. I hope I know what you're doing. Mindful social awareness, psychographics, demographics. So here's the customer persona. This slide is good, but I would add it at the end, like appendix. The thing is that there's a lot of information here, and I'm just hyping, I'm vibing right now, and I want to keep reading. I want to see this is the challenge, how are you solving it? I don't want to start reading about the demographics. Maybe if you highlighted it a little bit faster, it's a lot of text. As a presentation and design, this is pretty amazing. The presentation is really good. My only concern is we are on slide 3 and we're still describing the problem slash challenge. The thing that every entrepreneur does in the beginning, me included, is we want to keep talking about the problem. A problem, we spend 3-4 slides, and then we spend another 5-6 slides about talking about the solution. Tell me super fast the problem, like elevator pitch, and then immediately tell me what the solution. Now we're on slide 3 and I'm starting to get tired, hey, what's happening here? It's the third slide, I got it. Let's move. And the problem spans multiple industries. Host, health, cleaning tools, 30,000 men, beauty. So this is an excellent slide for me to understand what is the market size. And obviously here you said that it is the market size. So usually we have this slide after the solution, maybe even after the model. This is too early because at this moment I'm okay, I understand what's the challenge. People want a little bit more ethical products and environmentally friendly, but currently we're talking about the market and everything. I'm not in the investor mood right now. I just want to be informed about what's happening here. So it's not bad, obviously, but it's really good trying to conform to the way that pitch decks are done. It's good, it's good. Ha! You are watching this video and all of a sudden there is a break. Yeah, and you're wondering what happened. Why he stopped reviewing the pitch deck and all of a sudden he's talking directly to me. Yes, I'm talking directly to you. Thank you for watching, and probably we're around in the middle of the video. And I want to say that because you watched this video, you got some victory coins. What are victory coins? There are some currency, my cryptocurrency that I give to people that watch my videos, and I put these segments randomly in the video and they can exchange these coins with books, swag, get some hours with me to review their startup or help out or whatever. Last year we gave away books, I wrote some songs, crazy stuff. Subscribe, like, leave a comment below, I am awesome, and send me an email. You can find my email, you can find my email on my website, and I'll send you some coins and we'll take it from there. Thanks for watching, back to your video. We created to manufacture and sell fun sustainable products that allow families to become environmentally friendly. Nice. So the first slide should have been that's the challenge. Second slide, that's the solution. And then you start, you know, the more pitching. Yeah, then like after that you start, you know, really diving into. But yeah, I don't want to see like the first two slides. I don't want to see a lot of numbers. I don't want to see a lot of text. Like, keep the investor hooked at that moment. Okay. Solution. Second slide about the solution. Our product range spans multiple industries. Our subscription, so customers can get everything with ease and never have to run out. Supply chain transparency, customers. Maybe this should have been the second slide, because now I understand what the solution. Like, you have also a subscription model. I get some idea about how you're going to monetize this. I like it. I like. Currently, as I keep seeing this pitch deck, I know there is something there. I would prefer to be a little bit smaller, the intro. Revenue model, that's what I like. Like, immediately. Challenge, solution, here's how we make money. Revenue model, recurring revenue, my two favorite words. Model guarantees predictability, scalability, and convenience. Subscription, customers purchase at regular intervals, one-off purchases, wholesale B2B, blah, blah. Okay, legit. The size of the opportunity, the market. This would have been the market slide. Very nice positioning for the market slide. The scale of the opportunity is vast. Capital is just 1%, which doesn't give any revenue. So, this exactly like sentence, it's something that investors are not really fond of. Because when you say, if we capture 1% of 1 billion, we make tons of money, or 0.1%, we make tons of money. It's not that easy to capture 0.1% on a super competitive market. So I would dedicate that space to something else, because the moment I saw it, I'm like, hey, okay, read this thing many times, usually it doesn't work, you're gonna change the model, it doesn't work. So use that space somewhere else. Products marketed sustainable are driving 50% category market growth, correct. I think I've seen this before. You see, I don't even remember what was before because I wasn't ready to start processing the market. So it seems that I've seen this before. I'm not going to read it. This slide should have been replaced by the other one and this should have been removed. Bamboo toilet paper, pre-launch, sold. What? This is like epic. Like the traction, it's like fantastic traction. Actually, I know that bamboo paper like skyrocketing at this moment. Pre-launch November 2020, 10,000 rolls of toilet paper sold, gross margin 82, net margin 33. You see, now I'm like, oh, pre-launch, sold stuff, 30,000 sold to date. So, it's not an idea. Like, there is something there, there is some traction. 100% bamboo, plastic. And now I'm starting reading because I'm a little bit more involved and I want to learn more about it. Good value for money. Very nice. Very, very nice. So now you see, even though the presentation started, and to tell you the truth, most investors would just skip the second and third slide. The moment they hit here and they see there are some sales, they will definitely stop. So highlight these specific areas, highlight them more. You need to draw my attention right here. And to tell you the truth, even if you blew up the previous slides, which you didn't, this slide is your savior. Like, okay, whatever, we made money. But you want to optimize the flow. So, challenge, solution, here's how we make money. Very good slide. I'm very pumped. Private focus group, likes, Instagram followers, KPI. What is this slide about? These customers have an acquired. So maybe this is about the LTV and the CPA. The numbers are amazing. I will definitely do the whole site. Like, this confuses me because it has a lot of numbers that don't really make any sense for me. Like 385, is it a lot? It doesn't seem a lot, but it could be. I have no idea about the sector. So I don't know. These need to be definitely higher. Or have numbers like that. Instagram, 1,000 followers, a little bit maybe your engagement. More than 300 members, private focus group, or almost 400, something like that. KPI, Facebook, one product. Really good. These are like really good numbers. Financial forecast. 2022, year one, revenue, COGS, income negative, three. So the revenue goes up. COGS, four times, four. Yeah, to tell you the truth, this slide, I never really cared about as an entrepreneur and as an investor. I know that it's very difficult to hit these numbers and to predict what's going to happen, but it's good at least to see that there is some thought put behind into this and there is some significant value and revenue generated. I like it. I wasn't expecting it because usually when I review pitch decks, they forget to put customer testimonials. And as I said, it's good to keep the pitch decks, you know, at a very specific format because it makes it easier for angel investors and VCs to keep going through them. But sometimes when you have a nice surprise, it's really good to throw it there. So fantastic, fast delivery toilet paper, fast delivery fantastic toilet paper, good as it was, amazing brand. And you see, I see the testimonials and I'm like, okay, there are some actually customers because you have sales. I don't know if they are made up, but my first impression is like, okay, there are people love this product. Future product roadmap. 2021, toilet fist bombs, very, very good idea. 2022, zero waste. So you're expanding. Kitchen paper towel, dry cleaner, baby nappy. Very good. So you keep expiring, you have the brand, and then you keep adding more products and expanding while you're utilizing your user base, your customer base. Actually, very good. Probably these are more products. Yeah, remove this slide. I have no idea what this slide is. I know, like, in terms of design, it makes sense to have it here, but I don't know, is this the end? It's like an intermission. So let's remove that slide. The team, which is super important. CEO, MBA, and career in investment banking. Ethic, freelance, collaborative, ethos, national products, very nice. CMO, leader in paid advertising. Yes, you definitely need somebody that knows about paid advertisement. This is how the whole game is going to be run. He runs a growth marketing agency, offices in London and Los Angeles. Scaled many startups, very nice, 18-year experience. Small brands and money plant organic. Very good. So the team has experience, obviously, in products and more importantly, in how to acquire customers, you know, digitally and through paid advertising, which is very important for this brand. Very nice. Like, the team seems like super solid. Competitors. Very good slide at a very nice place. Very good slide. Direct competitors. Chiki Panda. I know the Eco Coconut. And the Eco Vibe. I didn't know that. That's actually interesting that there is no multi-industry product subscription based. I wonder why though. Usually when you're alone in a category, that's might be excellent, but usually it's not, because there might be a reason why these people haven't moved to a multi-product category or multi-industry product category. Maybe it's more expensive. I assume it's more expensive to focus on multiple products. Personally, I like it because I think it's the same user base, so you can keep upselling them the next product. So personally, I like it, but I'm just saying that some investors, they don't want you to be all alone, like right there. Investment in similar businesses, Mark Cuban with a partner, some future. Very good. So this slide now, got convinced, I know the market, I know what you guys are doing, that the revenue you have. And now you tell me, hey, you know what? It's not something that nobody has heard before. Like, there are bigger brands there, and there are people that actually invest in these companies, Robert Downey Jr. Very good. So you can tell me, now I'm seeing that there is something happening there in this sector. And without knowing the next slide, I hope the next slide is about an acquisition. So now the investor will start thinking like, okay, other people are investing there, there is a trend, but is there any acquisition? Let's hit the space. Oh, funding request, wow, you could have an acquisition. I hope it was an acquisition here. But let's see, funding request, £250,000 to grow the team, correct, launching new products. Of course, correct, turbocharged marketing, building B2B, makes absolute sense. And it's not a lot of money, like $250,000. The only thing I would add here is for how long, like this is for 1 year, for 6 months. Like it would be good to know why this money are needed. And maybe what's the next step? Because is this a seed round? Obviously it's a pre-seed seed round, but the next step is going for a Series A. Obviously it's not important, 100% important to put it here, but it would be nice to see like we're raising this money to do this, because with 250K, I don't think you will be able to launch 3 new products and marketing and everything. So it will help me understand what is the roadmap. Next strategy, this slide. This slide should be like the slide before. Yeah, because I was like, oh, people are investing in that, there is a trend, bam. And then, you know what? There's actually next strategy. Procter & Gamble just brought this venture back. Yes, obviously there's a very good exit strategy. So as an investor, I know that this is how I make my multiplier. This is how I get out of the startup. You just need to switch the slides, but very good slides, obviously. Why now? Rise of ethical consumerism, support generation, civil use. Very good. I would leave it there. Maybe I would think if I want to move it in the appendix. I don't know. It's not terrible. If it's like one or two slides before the last slide, I think it's okay. It's okay positioning. Actually, it was one slide. Perfect. Then it was perfect positioned. Reach out anytime you have any questions you can in our products, phone number, email, and the website. I love the somethingco.com. I love the website, and I love the branding, colors, everything. You guys, like, you really nailed it. Like, you nailed the whole palette. I don't think it's anything else. So I think that's about it. If you really enjoyed this pitch deck, let me know below in the comments. Please subscribe and like so I know that you like it and you want me to keep doing these pitch decks. If you want to reach out to the company, please reach out to them. They're raising money. Let's help more entrepreneurs build epic stuff. I know someone from my team will definitely reach out to this company to ask more information. And what else? I don't have anything else. Happy New Year. I hope you're not watching this video like 7 months later and you're wondering why this guy is saying New Year, because it's January 5th. Thank you all for watching. See you next time.